that shit anymore. You're going, honey, come on, it's protein. They're going, get out of here, it's dick bombing. We know better. And they do know better. They read the same damn men's magazines we do. Playboy, Penthouse. How many more of you guys read that shit? What is this, gay night? Two fucking guys on the hall. Everybody else going, well, you don't read that shit. We look at the pictures. What are you doing? Hey, what the hell are you two doing in there? It's all right, though. Don't worry about it. Women don't mind that now. They say, go ahead, look at them girls. Fall in love with them, because they know you ain't got a chance to down with me. I'm serious. Like this other magazine, Gallery Magazine, got the gallery girl next door. This girl next door, I live in the wrong damn neighborhood. Gallery girl next door, 5'9", blonde hair, blue eyes, lying naked on her back on a pool table with a carrot in her mouth. This is my neighbor. She's a short, fat, ugly little bitch with a... She'd be laying on that pool table with an apple in her mouth going, wait, get off that table! You got the dog alone. Sad state of affairs in our sexuality now. I'll tell you that. Can't get laid like you used to either, boy. It ain't safe. Even a suave 80s, 90s type of guy like myself has to be careful. Oh, I'm serious. I used to be the biggest fucking whore dog you was ever seen. Oh, I mean, I'd fuck anything in a skirt, girls, Scottish men. It ain't safe no more. Back in the 60s, you could fuck everybody up and down the block, then you get a cold sore. Now you shake your hands dead in 3 days. I hope I'm not offending any of you ladies here tonight, too, because I know a lot of you girls are probably sitting around now going, what a pig. What a chauvinistic fuck this guy. And you know, I used to be like that. But now I'm sensitive. I am, because I'm wearing a butt plug. And, I'm kidding, it's a dildo. No, it's a vibrator, but anyway, you know. Invented this gym, huh? Two guys sitting around in a bar one night and having a couple of brewskis, and one guy goes, hey, Merle, why don't you take that mango shake thing and just cram it up my ass? All right, that's more fun than Parcheesi. Look at that. If you're gonna buy one, how the fuck do you know what size fits you? They come in all different sizes and shit. What do you do, go up to the guy at the porno counter and go, what do you think, huh? That Mike Tyson model? Wrap it up. There you go. And I'll give you guys the most important word of advice to the men in the audience here right now. If you take this to your dying day, it'll save you a lot of heartache and headaches. Whatever you do, if you're going to make love to a woman, don't let her watch a porno movie with you first. Because these boys are professionals. I'm serious. They got like 16-inch dicks. You go inside to get changed, you leave her there on the couch, she's watching some chick take a telephone pole up her ass. You come back out in a short robe going, ta-da! What's that? It's my love stick. No, that's a toothpick. That's a love stick. Come on, honey, put your dick near the TV screen. See how you do. Go ahead. These guys are pros. They can suck their own dicks. I wish I could suck my own dick. I wouldn't have to do fucking comedy. I wouldn't do a damn thing. I'd stay in my room all fucking day. People be coming by going, Roger, you coming out? No, I'm tired. Leave me alone. I'm white. I'm sleeping. And I know every fucking guy in this theater here tonight would suck his own dick on speed. And it wouldn't make you gay if you're homophobic or something like that. It wouldn't. It'd just be a matter of convenience. I mean, hell, you know what you like, a little teeth, a little tongue, huh? Just as long as you didn't jizz it yourself. That's where you gotta go. Of course, you know, guys, we'd be lying. I'm gonna come. No, I'm not. Yes, I am. No, I'm not. Yes, I am. Of course, see, half the women are sitting here going, now you know how we feel. Now, see, if you were schizophrenic, then I think you'd be gay. Because then you'd be sucking into the personality. Be like, take it. No! Yes! No! Yes! Then you'd have four or five personalities, you'd be cheating on yourself. Like, he's mine. No, he's mine. No, he's mine. No, he's mine. Who do I choose? course, the only thing I'd worry about that is if it gave itself AIDS. Boy, would that be embarrassing to tell, wouldn't it? Your buddy would be calling you up. You been sucking dicks or something? Just no. Whoops. Oh, yeah. You gotta be careful with this shit. Like I said, even a suave, sensitive 80s type of cat like myself has to be careful. Oh, I know you're stoned. You're going rowdy. Not you. Me. It's true. Give you an example. Go out with this girl a couple months ago, beautiful girl. Go to her house, she's drinking a beer, a little wine, getting kissy face, huggy wuggy. I said, hey, cool your jets. I did. I said, nothing's going on tonight. I said, I want to establish a basis for a relationship with you. I said, after, you know, we've gone out for a while, we have some sensual feelings, like have a sexual encounter. It's apropos, that would be most delightful. I did. It's true.
It is.
I said, but after we've known each other for a while, you know, get like comfortable feeling everything, want to have a sexual relationship, everything has to be fine. And, you know, like maybe for instance for a night, like we'll go out and get a movie, grab some dinner, and come home, tie up, and jack off on your tits, and all that. She appreciated my sensitivity. Although I should have been tired before I left, but on that we got along our hack. And sometimes you step on people's religious convictions when it comes to sex, like I'm Catholic. Any Catholics? Come on, you got it, man. It's like being a member of Sam's Wholesale Club or something. Just wait for it. 10% off on volume sins. Hey, I gotta ask you something. I gotta break this up real quick. I gotta tell you a joke. Now, if I tell you a religious joke, will you not get mad?
Fuck!
All right, because I've done religious material before, and people got all kinds of fucking pissed off at me. But this is the funniest goddamn joke I've ever heard in my life. My buddy called me, he told me this in Waco. He says, you know why they crucified Jesus instead of stoning him? And I said, no. And he says, because if they had stoned him, instead of going like that, he'd have to be going.
I want you to feel uncomfortable.
trust me, your mouth has been rowdy. One day. Half an hour, I don't remember, I took all them pills.